As the last topic about theme development specifically, and of course there will be later several topics that relate to theme development, but not just theme development. As the last theme development topic, we'll talk about placement a bit. Placement is well documented on the documentation side, as you can see. A lot of content here, but first let me clarify what the goals of placement are and why we are using it. Well, going back to our site, you see that, for example, the blog displays its title, then it has a lot of other stuff. And the same happens with the blog post. It displays its title, then the subtitle, I think it is, image, etc., etc. And all of these come from different shapes, from different parts and fields. Placement is about the relation of these or configuring these shapes. Because sometimes the solution is not to completely override something, but for example, to just turn it off or change the order of shapes in between. And that's exactly what shapement is for. What placement is for. Shapement would be, a love child of a shape and a shipment or something. Now, on this documentation page, you see that we are talking about placement.json. Actually, placement.json files, placement files, are just one, let's call it API, where you can configure placement. But you can also configure that from code. And when we create our first content parts, we will actually do exactly that. For now, since we are just talking about a bit simpler theme development, we will use placement.json files. So let me actually create such a file, and then we'll take it from there. So let's go back to the theme again. And this will be a placement file. All right, so far so good. And the next is to understand what a placement.json file does. There is quite some explanation here, so I encourage you to check it out. We'll just see a simple example with title part. And here is a pretty complete example. Now, what a placement file contains, well, first of all, is JSON, so we have the brackets here. And secondly, it has such sections for everything that it places. So in this case, shapes for text field. And then it can have a variety of configurations. You can use placement to hide shapes or make them visible. You can change the order of shapes, which is possible with the place configuration here. You can also specify these rules for just specific content types, like it is here, or just for specific content parts in specific display types, or for specific differentiators, which is a field concept that makes it possible to identify when a specific field is displayed. Because you can have two text fields on the same content type, for example. The differentiator will help differentiate between those two text fields. And you can also target specific paths, so URLs. And you can also create alternates from here. So, as I said, alternates are alternative names for shapes, and that way you can override shape templates based on context. Like, you can override title part, but just in the summary display type, or just for blog posts. You can also add alternates like this. Furthermore, one thing that we didn't talk about yet is wrappers. Wrappers are, well, as the name suggests, shapes that go around, that wrap other shapes. You can use this to wrap specific pieces of markup into other pieces of markup for structure or styling reasons. Well, I would recommend more like for structural reasons. And one very curious thing here, the shape option as well, you can create another shape to be used instead of the currently displayed shape. But we'll make things a bit simpler. And let me just copy this and let's do something in the placement file. And I will actually put this on the side, as we again will have an easy way of doing it. So instead of text field, we'll have title part. And we'll play around title part just a little bit. And well, first of all, there is the place option or place property, where you can change where the shape of this part is actually placed. Now, I think by default, the title is placed in the header zone with some kind of weight 5. So what did I do here? The content shapes are divided into zones, just as the layout shape is divided into zones. But one thing here, the content shape is divided into local zones. Those zones are only available or only active in that current content shape. So that means that if you have a blog post displayed here, it will have a header zone and a content zone to put specific shape templates, content part and content field shape templates into them. But these zones are different from the global zones on the big layout. If you have two blog posts, they will have one header zone each, and for each of these blog posts, you will be able to put something into those zones. Whereas with global zones, they are global. There's just a single global content zone, for example, although the name is the same. So what we are telling Orchard here is to put style part into the header local zone with a weight of 5. Placement is mostly about putting shapes into specific places in a specific order. With the header local zone, we now have the specific place, and with 5, we also have the specific order. So if multiple shapes are put into the same zone, this will determine the order in which they are displayed. Because remember, Orchard is extensible and flexible. So currently, maybe there is only a single shape in that header zone, but soon enough, there can be another one, and somehow we need to determine which order in the order in which to display them. All right, so nothing really changed. That's what I expected. But let's change this to content. Oops. Content. And let's reload. And nothing really changes. And actually, the problem is that I forgot to stop the application. So now I'm stopping it, and let me restore it. Because placement is actually not like auto-loaded like Razor templates. So let's see what happens now. And now once it's loaded, we see that we have a strange order here for our blog post. Indeed, the title is now in the middle of this whole thing. But that's something that we expected because we moved it around. And we can actually also hide shapes. So if there is something displayed here that you don't want, then what you can do is that in the place configuration, you can just hit a hyphen. And unfortunately, still nothing will happen here. So I will need to stop the application and restart. So I started the application with ISExpress, which is the default when you hit Control F5 in Visual Studio, there was a little icon and at the taskbar to where you can kill it from. So that's what I did. And this is pretty much the anatomy of a placement file. As you can see, title is has now disappeared. I will actually put it back into the header zone because, well, we need a title still, right? So let's put it, let's put it in the header zone. Now, this is the anatomy of a placement file. It's a JSON file, JSON as usual. It can contain any number of references to shapes, and you can combine all of these rules here as you wish. And remember that you can also write a placement from code. This with placement.info file, placement.json files as well. One way to do it, I would say, sometimes it's the simpler way to do it if you are just doing theme development.